manslaughter charges for the death of 13-year-old Max Benson stood before an El Dorado County judge for the first time today. We were only allowed to take still photos of Benson's special education teacher, Kimberly Woland, his principal, Star Ann Myers, and the school's executive director, Cindy Keller. But all three pleaded not guilty.
It is always a tragedy when there is a loss of life, especially such a young life.
Linda Parisi represents Keller and Myers, both of whom used to own Guiding Hands School.
These two women have dedicated literally their entire lives to helping, educating, encouraging, and working with special needs students. They have a 25-year history of exemplary service to this community.
But their attorney was not the only one speaking on their behalf.
These are probably two of the most moral people you have ever met, and in a million years, they would never harm a child.
Cindy Brown made these signs she displayed outside the courthouse. She says Guiding Hands was a godsend for five of her adopted children who had autism and have since had trouble finding the same services elsewhere.
What people don't realize, they always say, oh, we'll put them somewhere. I would like the address of somewhere. A lot of them have nowhere to go.
Also defending the three accused was former Guiding Hands teacher Kyle McCoy, who worked at the school at the beginning of the last school year it was open.
I feel like they possibly think that there was some kind of inappropriate procedures done, or maybe there was not correct training done, or things like that, which I would say is completely false.
And the judge ruled that all three of those defendants are not a flight risk. However, he did say they could no longer teach nor run any sort of daycare facilities. They will be back in court in January. Reporting live, Doug Johnson, Fox 40 News.
Doug, thank you.